front of the family. I've taken to you. So strong, it's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself willing.
Wednesday lover, Wednesday lover, Wednesday lover. There's no other.
More than I want,
more than I got, more than I ever would need.
When I want to get to God, I sing songs like, "Great is thy faithfulness."
Hi, you guys. It's Invincible. I don't feel good. But I so wanted to do this topic about faith. So if you don't mind, I'm going to do this topic from my bed, okay? Yeah. Let me sit up. I know I look crazy, I look crusty. That's how I feel. But can we talk about faith? I'm mustering up some strength on the inside to talk about this.
I heard a conversation the other day between two Christians. One was a backslider and he's lost his faith in Christ. He began to tell the Christian about his experiences, and this is what he said. He said, "I've been so sick, in and out of the hospital, just from one sickness to the other." And the Christian said, "Tell me about it." And as they talked, the backslider said, "I don't even think I can get well." And the Christian said, "Where is your faith? Tell me where is your faith in God?"
Okay, here we go. This is a little bit better. I could not give you "Laying Down" and not Olive Morris. All right, so let's talk about what faith is and then go into what happens when you lose your faith. And for me, I'm going to give you a real simple solution on how to get it back, all right? So everybody, let me ask you, what is faith? We said we have it. We said we use it. But can you define it? At least define it in your own way. What is faith? Give you a second. Some people are stumped. Some people aren't. Here we go. Faith. The acronym that I have for faith is "Forsaking All, I Trust Him." Forsaking all, I trust him. To forsake all means I'm leaving it behind. I am forgetting it. And then I'm trusting him. Who's him? Him in my case is God. Let me say this. I'm going to be abundantly clear. You don't have to go to church to have faith. I'm not going to say that the only people who have faith are Christians. I will say this. As a Christian, I see results from having faith in God. Take it how you want. Do what you need with it. Come back and chew it up. Swallow it. Hopefully it'll help you out. So, when talking about faith, I can't help but get excited. And I have some strong faith. I have strong faith because I've been some places and done some things, and oh my God, it was faith and faith only that got me out of those situations. Well, Invincible, that's all fine and good. I'm so glad you got faith, but I've lost mine, and I need you to help me out. If your faith is so strong, hasn't it gotten weak before? And when it's gotten weak, Invincible, what did you do? This is what the topic is about. Tell me, Invincible, help me out. I need it. Hello. So if you've lost your faith and you're trying to get it back, let me help you out. I turn 32 this upcoming Sunday. So I'm going to use the age of however old I was as a chapter in my life. Now, it's no secret. I haven't been doing well. And it's some health issues. But I've had these health issues before. So, I'm not new to it. I'm true to it. But, one thing I know is that I'm going to be better. Going into chapter 32. This happened to me back in chapter 29. Chapter 29. You've seen pictures of it. I was in the hospital. I've showed you that before. But, if God did it before then, I know without a shadow of a doubt that he'll do it again now. That's what faith is. That's how you pick it back up, is by simply thinking back. Remember, he's bought you out of some things before. If he did it then, he can do it now. Y'all, that's it. That's all I have to say about faith. If you lose it, remember, he's done it before. And say it's something new. If he hasn't done it for you before, he's done it for somebody else. And use that person as an example. Alright? I'm out. Love y'all.